Oh Ramadan, oh Ramadan, month of mercy you are, welcome Ramadan.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ومن آياته أن خلقكم إِذَا أَنْتُمْ بَشَرٌ تَنْتَشِرُونَ وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُم مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِّتَسْكُنُوا لتسكنوا إليها وجعل بينكم مودة ورحمة إن ومن آياته خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف ألسنتكم وألوانكم إن في ذلك لآيات للعالمين ومن آياته منامكم بالليل والنهار وابتغاؤكم من فضله إن في ذلك لآيات ومن آياته يريكم البرق خوفا وطمعا وينزل من السماء ومن آياته أن تقوم السماء والأرض بأمره ثم وله من في السماوات والأرض كل له قانتون وهو الذي وله المثل الأعلى في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم صدق الله العظيم.
مصطفى أرمى نزحنا بأول يوم برمضان، طلعنا قعدنا بعقربات، قعدت تحت الزيتون، ما حد استقبلنا، يعني ضلينا مدة أكثر من 3 أو 4 شهور، وطلعنا لهوني. توفي بقذيفي بعيد عنكم. والله كيف ما بتذكر بتذكر يا أخي، إيش الواحد صعب، يعني إيش الواحد كنا بالبيت وشفناها اللي هداك ضربت. والله هي قتل بقتل يا أخي، الله بيصبر الإنسان اللي برقبته 5 أولاد، إيش بدي يسوي يا أخي. والله ساعدني الولا، يعني منين ما في حدا يا أخي ساعدنا. الخيام وقت تشتي الدنيا ينهى وصار شوي، والله هديك اشتريتها فوق 60,000، باعوني أول ما طلعنا. يعني بحس الواحد يموت أريح مي يدوق هذا الذل، وهال وقت بشو حس بح هالموقف اللي بتوقف هيك، يعني وقت الإنسان وقت بيجي بيطالبك وما معه، إيش عملت يا أخي؟ الله بيصبر الإنسان، الله بيصبر الإنسان اللي برقبته 5 أولاد، إيش بدي يسوي يا أخي؟ يا أخي بحطه وصار بك، يعني منقهرة، يعني بنقهر بنزعج هيك على هالشغلة هاي. كيف الواحد ما بينقهر؟ طلبوا شغلي هيك ثقيلة وما بقدر أأمن لهم إياها، لباس لباس بيشتهوا اللباس، بلاقيها على حالة ثقيلة ما في يا أخي مادي، يعني كثير ضعيفة ما بقدر أأمن لهم إياها، أأمن لهم هيك شغلي فرحهم، هاي بنبسط فيها، يعني هاي اللي بأأمن لهم أكلي أو بحبوها أو أي شيء، يعني هاي بنبسط فيها. والله ميتة هيك عايش هالولاد، لبسهم وكبرهم، ويعني هاي ميتة كلياتها، نقعد هيك نتقاوي مثل الله خلقهم قاعدين.
One of the things many of you probably know about Musa alayhi salam is that he's the most mentioned messenger of Allah in the Quran. Allah Azza wa Jalla talks about him more than any other prophet by name. And Musa alayhi salam, one of his stellar qualities in the Quran is that there are many, many du'as recorded from him in the Quran. And this is one of them. And this du'a is particularly powerful. Musa alayhi salam, his story is mentioned in so many places, and this particular ayah belongs to Surah Taha, the 20th surah. And in this surah, Allah Azza wa Jal begins the narrative when he left his family and he saw a fire up on top of a mountain in the middle of the night. And he told his family to wait and to go see this fire. And when he gets up there, of course, he discovers that Allah Azza wa Jal is the one that's called him to it. Now in the course of that talk that Allah was giving him through the fire, Allah Azza wa Jal told him to throw his stick, his staff, al-asa. Musa alayhi salam throws it and it turns into a hayya, into a running snake. A poisonous snake in old Arabic is also called a hayya. A snake whose fangs are out is also called a hayya. So it's running around, the snake is running around. And then he tells him, خُذْهَا وَلَا تَخَفْ. Grab the snake, grab it and don't be afraid. Now you tell me, as a normal human being, grabbing a snake and not being afraid, you know, it's almost impossible. And yet Allah Azza wa Jal trained Musa alayhi salam to take this task on, to grab the snake and not be afraid. And at this point you notice Musa alayhi salam doesn't say, لا أستطيع يا ربي. I can't do it, يا رب. No dua to Allah to say, Ya Allah help me, he just does it. وَضْمُمْ يَدَكَ إِلَىٰ جَنَاحِكَ تَخْرُجْ بَيْضَاءَ مِنْ غَيْرِ سُوءٍ آيَةً أُخْرَى. Put your hand in your pocket, in your sleeve, you take it out, it's going to be white. Another miracle I'm giving to you. لِنُرِيَكَ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا الْكُبْرَى. اذهب الى فرعون انه طغى. This is to show you from the greatest of my miracles, of our miracles. Go to Fir'aun. He's rebelled. Now so far Allah has asked him for a few things, some pretty shocking things. He's asked him to grab a snake. He's asked him to, you know, his hand has changed in color entirely. But Musa alayhi salam has no reaction. He's fine to all of this. But when Allah tells him, go to Fir'aun. Go to Fir'aun. He's the one, in fact, that has rebelled. At this point, Musa alayhi salam makes dua. And so now we're learning that when Allah tells us to do something, and it's hard, sometimes we think things are hard, but you know, if you have courage, Allah lets you do it. But you get to a point where you think, even I, with all my courage, this is even too hard for me. That is the time you turn to Allah, and you don't say, Ya Allah, I can't do it. You ask Allah for what you need, so you can do it. So now, what does he ask? It's incredible. He's going to go to Fir'aun. Fir'aun is up in the castle, in the most secure building in all of Egypt. So he can't hide. He has to go directly all the way to the doors of that White House back in the day. And he has to knock on the doors of security. And he has to say, I have an appointment with Fir'aun. And all of these police officers and all this security guard, what are their instructions? Kill him immediately. Kill him immediately. So I would expect that he would turn to Allah and say, Ya Rab, you want me to go talk to Fir'aun? Can you deal with his army? Can you put them all to sleep so I can go talk to him? Or can you pull him out of Egypt so I can talk with him over here? It might be safer for me. You know? Or can you just magically fly me over there and I'll just end up in the castle and I can talk to him and my problem is solved. You want me to speak to him? I'll speak to him that way. Because I won't even get to him. Actually, in this dua, what he asks for is remarkable. He says, أَوَّلًا رَبِّ شْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي Ya Allah, my master, expand my chest. When he thinks about going to Fir'aun, all of these thoughts are going in his mind, and he's becoming nervous, he's becoming scared, he's becoming worried. Am I going to be able to do this? Am I going to get killed? Ya Allah, the first thing I need to do to fulfill your command is I need to calm down. There are times where I'll be afraid, there are times where I'll be angry, there are times where I might even get depressed because I see no results, this guy's not changing. I might go through a score of negative emotions, and Ya Allah, you need to give me something that will keep me emotionally stable and positive. And then he says, وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي And Ya Allah, you make my mission easy for me. You make my mission easy for me. You're the one who gave me this mission. But as skilled as Musa alayhi salam is, and has Allah's choice is perfect, when Allah chose Musa alayhi salam to take on Fir'aun and to challenge him, there's no better qualified candidate on the face of the earth at the time than Musa alayhi salam. So Allah knows what he's doing. He's right for the job. And now we're learning, even if you're the most qualified to do a job, your qualifications, as good as they are never enough. Allah has to make ease on his end. Allah will make ease on his end. And these two things have to come together. Musa alayhi salam has to make his effort. But his effort alone will not give victory. It will come when Allah makes the task easy.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to another amazing episode of Ramadan TV. Tonight is the first night of Ramadan, and alhamdulillah, this is the first time since 2019 that we've been able to perform Tarawih in the masjid. So we have two blessings. The first one is Ramadan, and the second one is that we're able to pray in the masjid, alhamdulillah. I hope and I ask Allah that this year is even more blessed than the years before, and inshallah, it's just as fruitful as you wish it to be and more. Inshallah, we're here at Marian Masjid, Masjid Umar ibn al-Khattab in Park Home. And we're going to be coming inside and doing the first of the Ramadan quizzes, which I know everyone normally looks forward to and learns so much from. So let's get going inside and do some Ramadan TV.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الصلاة خير من النوم الصلاة خير من النوم الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة محمدا الوسيلة والفضيلة وابعثه مقاما محمودا الذي وعدته إنك لا تخلف الميعاد
السلام عليكم First of all, I want to say how beautiful it is to see you all again in the masjid in Ramadan. Takbir! Allah. Alhamdulillah. One whole year, no Ramadan in the masjid. How beautiful does it feel now? Ya salam. Alhamdulillah. We should pray twice as much. So, Sheikh, tonight, 16 rak'at. Sheikh Riyad. Alhamdulillah, we have Ramadan in the masjid. We do double. 20 rak'at. Inshallah, you say 20 or stick with 8? 8? 20? 28. No, I'm joking. Inshallah, we stick with 8. All right. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulullah. Good to see you, alhamdulillah. First of all, assalamu alaikum, and Ramadan Mubarak to you all. As you know, did you guys watch the first episode of Ramadan TV? Yes? Some yes, some no? All right, so on channel 44 and on Facebook and on YouTube, we're streaming live Ramadan TV, channel 44. Yeah, Ramadan TV, and obviously one of the popular segments, and we always get requests to do this again and again, is the Ramadan quiz. So as we know tonight, we're going to be doing the quiz. Obviously, it's the first night of Ramadan in the masjid. Normally we bring Zamzam water, but we couldn't get access to Zamzam water tonight. So instead, as a gift, I got, not this face mask. I got Maltesers, inshallah, to give you some energy for tahajjud, okay? Inshallah. So very simple, we got 10 questions and I want 10 answers. Now the way that we do it is you got to put your hand up, I point at you, you give the answer. If it's correct, you get Maltesers. If it's wrong, we go to the next person. All right? Sounds good? Inshallah. Now I need someone that can help me. Who can come and help me? I need a little helper. You? Come. MashaAllah. He's got his face mask as well, MashaAllah. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum salam.
What's your name?
Yasin.
Yasin, MashaAllah. Beautiful name, MashaAllah. Can we all give a takbir for Yasin? Takbir. Alright, so it's very easy. When someone gets the answer right, I'm going to give you one of these chocolates. You can't eat it. You have to give it to the other person. Alright? Inshallah, no worries. Okay, is everyone ready?
Yeah.
MashaAllah. Alright, bismillah. So question number one. When does fasting in Ramadan become obligatory on a person? When does fasting Ramadan become obligatory on a person? This is a very simple one. Yes? 13 years old. That's not quite the right answer, but I think you're onto something. Yes? Yes? Yeah? When they are baligh or mature. So when they hit puberty. Yes? Correct? Yes, mashallah. Takbir. All right. Run to him and give him the Maltesers. Mashallah. Good job. Question number two. When it is time for Maghrib, one should one break the fast first or pray first? When it comes time for Maghrib, should they pray first or break their fast first? I saw his hand come up first. Yes? Huh? Pray first? Is that the right answer? No, alright, yes, Amin.
Break
your
fast.
Break their fast, yes, mashallah. Takbir. On dates, not on Maltesers. Inshallah. Okay. I just gave away half of the first answer, the next answer. So, when we break our fast, what's the drink and the food that we should break our fast on, in which the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam used to break his fast on? Tamar, dates, and ma, and water as well. Is that correct?
Yes.
Yes, mashallah. Takbir. Alrighty. Good job. Alright. Next one is, on which days of the year is it haram to fast?
Eid?
Which Eid? Eid al-Fitr, Eid al-Adha.
Yes.
And Eid al-Adha. We're trying to keep it simple. So the two Eid, it's haram to fast. We can't fast on the days of Eid. MashaAllah. Takbir. Okay. Abiyya, Abiyya. No, no, Abiyya. Abiyya, Abiyya. It reminds me of the Sahaba. When one was thirsty, they would get given water and then they'd give it to the next brother and say, he needs it more. Until they would go all the way around. MashaAllah. May Allah unite us with them, Ya Rab. All right. How many poor people should a person feed for missing an obligatory fast for a valid reason if he or she is unable to make it up? So I'll repeat the question again. How many poor people should a person feed for missing an obligatory fast for a valid reason if he or she is unable to make it up?
Yes. 60.
No. Yes. No. Yes. Huh? No. Yes. Ya salam. One. You miss one day, you pay for one day. You miss 2 days, you pay for 2 days, two people. So one person, one day.
So we deliberately.
Huh? Yeah, because we're getting all the things of Hajj and Fidya and Kafara, we're getting all mixed up together. So we need to be clear that if we miss an obligatory fast for one day for a valid reason and we are unable to make it up, we pay the Fidya for one day. MashaAllah. Takbir. I should give you 2 boxes of Maltesers for that one, but I've only got one for you. MashaAllah. All right. Which of the following people, this is a multiple choice question. Which of the following people do not have to fast and can make it up later? A, a farmer. B, an athlete. C, a traveler. Or D, a doctor.
Traveler.
Yes. A traveler, is that correct?
Yes.
What about a farmer if it's a hard day at work? No? Traveler? Ya Allah, bismillah, mashallah. Takbir! Good job. Okay. Which is a common mistake that Muslims around the world make during the last 10 nights? This is a common mistake they make during the last 10 nights. Yes.
They pray nafil and miss the fard.
They pray nafil and miss the fard? They could, but that's not as common as this one.
No, they
Yes? Yes, salam. They think Laylatul Qadr is the 27th only. And is it the 27th?
Yeah.
It might be. But it's a common mistake thinking that it's only on the 27th. And it could be when? Any of the last 10 nights. MashaAllah. Takbir. MashaAllah. Good job. And we ask Allah that He allows us to witness Laylatul Qadr, whichever night it may be. The laws of fasting in Ramadan were revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam in which city? No. Yes. Yeah? Medina, mashallah. Yes. The laws of fasting were not revealed in Mecca, they were revealed in Medina. All right, we're almost done. We've got 2 more. According to the Quran, what's the objective? What's the ultimate goal that Muslims try to achieve by fasting? Yes. Huh? Taqwa, yes. Not to lose weight. Not to feel with the needy. Not with the ultimate goal behind fasting. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ تَقْوَى. And that is being conscious of Allah. So even if you're fasting and you're at home and no one's around and there's a fridge full of food. See, when you get hungry? Fridge full of food and no one can see you except Allah. You say, nope, I continue fasting. So this is the objective behind fasting, mashallah. All right. The last one? Mean. Okay. What do you say? The last person that gets this is Yasin, but you still have to give the answer. So you have to win up for him.
Yeah?
Yeah. All right. Wal amilina alayhi. They get part of the zakat. Huh? All right. This is a very simple one. Which of the following should be our intention when fasting? A, to lose weight. B, to save money. C, to please Allah. Or D, to please our parents. Yes?
To please Allah.
What is it?
To please Allah.
Yes, salam. He wants to please Allah. MashaAllah. Takbir. Ya Allah. All right. And look what Allah has given you. Allah had written this Maltesers just for you. MashaAllah. Takbir. MashaAllah. MashaAllah. Zakumullah khair. I hope we learned something from these quizzes, and inshallah we enjoyed it. Tune into channel 44 to watch Ramadan TV so we continue benefiting throughout all of Ramadan, and keep us and the ummah in your dua. Zakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Zakumullah khair.
ولو بسط الله الرزق لعباده لبغوا في الأرض ولكن ينزل بقدر ما يشاء إنه بعباده خبير بصير.
Allah Azza wa Jal says, if we had opened up the doors of our rizq, if we had given our sustenance to our servants, لبغوا في الأرض, they would have gone beyond the measure. They would have gone to a level of haram. They would have done something that they should not do. وَلَكِنْ يُنَزِّلُ بِقَدَرٍ مَا يَشَاءُ. Instead, Allah reveals with His qadr as much as He wants to whomever He pleases. Now this verse tells us a very interesting reality. Allah gives those whom He loves just enough for them to not go beyond the bounds. Allah is saying, I know how much you're capable of. And if I were to give you everything, then you would go beyond what is halal, what is permissible for you. And this same sentiment is demonstrated in the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In a hadith in Sahih Bukhari, it is narrated that the Prophet was giving someone money, or he was giving a group of people money. One of the Sahaba said, O Messenger of Allah, why don't you give so and so? For wallahi, I think he's a mu'min, he's a good guy, give it to him. And the Prophet ignored him. And he kept on giving to other people. Second time the Sahabi said, Ya Rasulullah, give to him, for wallahi, I think he's a mu'min. And he ignored him for a second time. A third time he ignored him. And then our Prophet ﷺ turned and said to him, oh so and so, sometimes I give money to people and I don't give to those whom I love more, i.e. the beloved I don't give to, out of a fear that that money will be a temptation that will drag them into Jahannam. In other words, our Prophet ﷺ knows the people. And he is saying, what you're saying about this man might be right. He's a mu'min, he's a good guy. But he doesn't have that type of, if you like, patience with money. That he might do something that is not appropriate with that money. And therefore, dear brothers and sisters, what we learn from this ayah and from this hadith is very simple. And that is, what we do not have, and we tried to get it, we didn't get it, we should be content that Allah has a plan. That Allah knows how much He's giving. وَلَكِنْ يُنَزِّلُ بِقَدَرٍ مَا يَشَاءُ. Allah reveals with His qadr as much as He pleases. That person. In the end of the same surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the same fact, but this time about children. Allah says in the Quran, He is the one who blesses with children. يَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ إِنَاثٍ. To some He gives all daughters. وَيَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ الذُّكُورِ. To some He gives all men, all boys. أَوْ يُزَوِّجُهُمْ ذُكْرَانًا وَإِنَاثًا. And some families, they have boys and girls. وَيَجْعَلُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ عَقِيمًا. And some people have no children. إِنَّهُ عَلِيٌّ قَدِيرٌ. This is the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows who to give what to. And Allah knows how much to give. And Allah knows who to test people with. And therefore, the believer who believes in qadr, one of the main benefits of believing in qadr is that you feel a contentment of the heart. Whatever has happened because of qadr. As I said many times, qadr is used to calm down and to find release from a calamity. And qadr is not used to justify a sin. Qadr is used to find peace in whatever Allah has decreed. You didn't get the job, qadr Allah. You didn't make the million that you were looking to get from the business, qadr Allah. You didn't have this, you didn't get that. You tried, you made dua to Allah. You didn't get it. Now the point is you have to try. If you didn't try, then that's your problem. But you have to try. You want the job. You want the business. You want to get married. You try. If it doesn't happen, that's when we say, Qaddar Allah.
La 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 la
Welcome to the Old Bazaar Market. During Ramadan and every day of the year, we provide a large variety of services to the community. At the Old Bazaar Market, we have a masjid where Taraweeh prayers will be held every night. There are many halal food vendors for iftar, as well as clothes, jewelry, gift and Islamic shops. For your peace of mind, we have a fully supervised playhouse and trampoline park for kids. There is also a large community hall for weddings and functions. Our goal is to provide a family-friendly entertainment center for all ages and cultures. We are open 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. every single day of the year.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Wishing all our dearest brothers and sisters a blessed Ramadan. Imagine for a moment that your mother, daughter, father or son was taken away from you by the government for owning a copy of the Quran, for fasting, for praying, for saying the simple greeting of Assalamu alaikum. How would you feel? Our Uyghur Refugee Appeal provides urgent support for victims of the ongoing genocide with life necessities such as food, shelter, education, and medical aid. Visit our website at shukrfoundation.org.au.
Oh Ramadan, oh Ramadan, month of mercy you are, welcome Ramadan. Oh Ramadan, oh Ramadan, month of mercy you are, welcome Ramadan. Oh Ramadan, oh Ramadan, month of mercy you are, welcome Ramadan. Oh Ramadan, oh Ramadan, month of mercy you are, welcome Ramadan. Oh Ramadan, oh Ramadan, month of mercy you are, welcome Ramadan. Ramadan, Ramadan.
Ramadan is a month of mercy. Every year many people around the world struggle to find food to break their fast. Let's together this Ramadan give them joy and happiness.
Month of mercy you are, welcome Ramadan.